Andy, did you hear that? Come on, will you?
Did I hear what?
That whistle. That's the Rinso White whistle.
And Rinso means us.
That's right. Rinso gets clothes Rinso White. And Rinso presents the Amos and Andy Show. With Shorty the Barber, Gabby the Lawyer, the Mystic Knights of the Sea Quartet, and Hattie McDaniel. Rinso for a wash that's...
Rinso white.
Rinso for a wash that's...
Rinso white.
Rinso safe, soapy rich suds get out stubborn dirt fast. So as little as a 5-minute run in your washer gets all your whitewash dazzling Rinso white. Gaily colored washables come out Rinso bright. No wonder Rinso is the only soap recommended by the makers of 33 leading washers. Among them, your treasured Kenmore. Remember, though, there'll be no new Kenmore washers made for some time. So see your local Sears store for any service needs on your Kenmore. And next wash day, remember...
Rinso white.
Rinso white. Happy little wash day song.
And now our stars, Amos and Andy. Well... Andy's broke again. I say broke, he's demolished. To make matters worse, a few days ago, he rented a room and has discovered that his landlady is a most unreasonable person. She insists on the rent being paid. At the moment, Andy is just about to enter his room to show it to the Kingfish.
Come in, Kingfish, come in.
Hello there, Andy. You say, you know, I ain't seen your new room before.
Yeah, well, take a look around.
Hmm?
What'd you think of it?
The walls cracked, the plaster falling off there, floorboards up, windows broke. The general pattern ain't detoured through here by any chance, is it?
You don't like it, huh?
Well, and, can't you talk to the landlady and get her to fix up the place a little bit?
Look, Kingfish, I ain't gonna talk to that landlady about nothing. She's talking to me too often as it is, and only about one thing. The rent.
Now, wait a minute, sir. We can report her to the OPA for that.
The OPA?
Sure, the OPA. Why, there must be a ceiling on how many times she can ask you for your rent. I don't think she can ask you no more for the rent than more times than she did in 1942.
Well, I don't know about that. I've been stalling her off every day, and she says she ain't gonna stand for it no more. I still ain't got no money, but... I might have to soft sofa a little.
Yeah.
Oh, me. There she is now. Come in.
Oh, hello, Miss McDaniel. Nice of you to drop in. Something you want to discuss with me?
Yeah, and it ain't the weather.
Must be about the rent, huh? Well, I got a little surprise for you. I'm going to pay you the room rent.
Oh, you is? Well, I certainly will appreciate it, Mr. Brown. If I has been a little cross with you, you must excuse me.
Yeah, well, there's just one thing about it I gotta explain to you.
That's all, brother. Get out! Get out!
Wait a minute, y'all. We just a minute, y'all, madam. You can't throw my good friend out of this place. I'm sorry, but you just can't do it.
Who are you?
Madam, permit me to introduce myself. I was happy to say that I was George Kingfish Stevens.
It don't take much to make some people happy.
Hey, wait a minute, sir. Now, you can't talk to me that way. I ain't no ordinary riffraff, you know.
You ain't? What kind of riffraff is you?
Listen, Miss McDaniel.
Listen, nothing. I come here to get my rent, and that's what I want. Now, I've been waiting a week and...
Oh, hold it, hold it, hold it, Miss McDaniel. Hold it just a second. Just hold your face the way you got it there. Yeah, don't move, don't move. Oh, you is the most beautiful woman I done ever seen.
Pretty.
Oh, you really beautiful. Ain't nobody ever told you that before?
Just the rumors that don't pay.
Mr. Brown's right. You is beautiful.
Listen. I got an idea you two is just trying to talk me out of the rent here. I want my money.
Yeah, we back to that again, huh?
Look, I'm going to give you just one more week to get that rent money, or out you go. And that's final.
I tell you, Emma, is if I don't get some money, it's going to come my way fast, I'm going to be kicked out of my room, you know?
Yeah, well, that ain't the nicest thing that could happen to you.
And what I need is a big chunk of money, so I ain't going to have to worry for a while.
Yeah, you know, fellas, I thought that I was going to get a lot of money there one time, $500.
Wait a minute, what you mean, Emma?
Well, a camera supply company down the street that's running a contest. The contest is the one that sends in the picture of the most beautiful child in Harlem gets $500 prize.
Yeah, well, why didn't you send in your little girl, Arbadella's picture? She's a beautiful child, all right.
Yeah, well, that was my idea, but then I found out that the contest was only for children that's under 3 years old, you see. Arbadella is 7, and she's a big gal.
Yeah, well, who knows she's 7? Tell them that she's going to be 3 next month. Yeah, she just happens to be crazy about vitamins, that's all.
Oh, I wouldn't do that, Kingfish. I could get in trouble, and besides, she's very tall, even for 7.
Tall? That don't matter, Amos. She just happened to be a tall child, that's all. Was a tall baby. Well, I seen a man once in a circus that was 9 feet tall. Must have been over 6 feet tall when he was born.
Yeah, the thing is, say, Amos, looking out the window there, there's a customer out there trying to get in your cab.
Well, I'll see you fellas later. So long.
So long, so long. You know, Kingfish, it's too bad we can't get in on that pitcher contest. Amos talking about them pitchers has got me thinking. All I think about now is pitchers and more pitchers. Wish I had 15 cents. I'd go to the movies.
Now, wait a minute, Ender. Wait a minute, yeah. I got an idea.
Yeah?
Say, you know that picture of a baby that Shorty has got hanging up in his barbershop?
Oh, yeah. I think it's his nephew or something.
Yeah, well, now, wait a minute. Look here. There is a beautiful baby. Every time I go in there, I look at it.
Yeah.
If we sent that picture in, we'd win the $500 like nothing.
Oh, you got something there, Kingfish. Yeah. Wait a minute, but how is we going to get the picture with Shorty right there in the barbershop?
Wait a minute, that'll be easy, Andy. Wait a minute, now look here. We'll just convince Shorty that he looked run down and instead of just giving everybody else face massages, it's about time that he had one himself. Then when we gets the hot towel over his face and eyes, you grabs the picture.
Well, now wait, in case you don't remember, he got that picture in a frame nailed to the wall.
Well, take a hammer and a screwdriver along with you. That's all it is to it. Come on, Ender. Well, hello there, Shorty. Good to see you again.
Yeah, hiya, Shorty.
Oh, hiya, fellas. How is you?
Yeah, well, we just fine, Shorty. We just fine. Yeah, too bad you ain't looking so good. You seems to be on your last legs.
Now, listen, my insurance company just checked me up yesterday for a new policy.
Yeah, what'd they say?
They say that I was the most perfect condition they ever did. I was one of the best specimens of manhood. I got the most iron constitution. I could live to be 100. Turn me down.
Well, you really look bad, all right, Shorty. Your face is all drawn and thin there.
Yeah, that's right, Shorty. Even the bags under your eyes don't look as healthy as they used to.
Well, that's cause when I go to bed at night, I can't sleep.
Can't sleep? Is you doing anything for it, Shorty?
Well, once I tried sleeping with my feet higher than my head so that all my blood could rush to my head and then put me to sleep. But it didn't work out, though.
Not enough sleep?
Not enough blood.
Shorty, there's only one thing that can unlatch a man as tired as you is, and that's a face massage with a hot towel. And me and Andy is going to give you one.
Oh, you don't know how. It takes skill and experience. For example, do you know how to judge the heat of a hot towel?
Well, how does you do it?
Well, when I give a customer a facial, I first pick up the hot towel, and then if it's too hot to hold in my hand,
yeah,
I drops it on his face.
Yeah, I guess that's the best way, all right. Now, okay, Shorty, now tell you what. Now, come on with you. Now, just hop in the chair there, and I'll show you what I mean. Now, get up there.
Well, I don't know. Well, all right.
Yeah. That's fine. No, let me lay you down here. Now, just lean your head back there. That's it. Now, get a towel here and some hot water here. Mm-hmm. Now this towel is just about right.
Yeah, just slap it on my face.
Yeah, now, let me get the towel right over your eyes there. That do the trick. Now, just cover up your eyes there. Now, I'll leave your mouth uncovered so you can breathe.
Mm.
Oh, baby mine, now is the time, oh, baby mine.
I got you, King.
What's Andy doing?
My brother Andy, he's just sitting over there at your manicure table, manicuring his nails a little.
Sure got tough nails, ain't he?
Yeah. File ain't no good on his nails. Can't use a file. You really got to smack him, that fella. Tough nails, all right. Bad cuticle, too, yeah.
Okay, Kingfish, okay. I'll see you fellas later. So long.
So long, brother Andy, old pal. So long. Well, Shorty, now I'll take the towel off here. The face massage is over.
Is that all there is to it?
Oh, yeah. It's the technique more than anything else. Take this looking glass.
Yeah, give it here.
Now, tell me the truth. Don't your face look a lot better?
Oh, yeah. My face look a lot better now. My skin has the smoothest texture. My skin ain't got no more of them wrinkles. My skin is just like a baby. My skin is so smooth, I prune face.
The Mystic Knights of the Sea Quartet singing The Little White Horse and the Mare.
Romeo and Juliet were quite a famous pair, according to the books of history.
And here's another great romance you'll see it at the fair. On exhibition anyone can see.
The little white horse on the merry-go-round fell in love with the little gray mare. He's been tagging her around
merry-go-round at the fair.
Now the little white horse on the merry-go-round found the question to the little gray mare. Ask her if she'd marry him
on the merry-go-round at the fair.
The calliope played the wedding march. All the animals began to sing.
Oh, the zebra winked at the tall giraffe as
the mare took the little brass ring.
Now the little white horse and the little gray mare still honeymoon round and round.
You'll always see them at the fair, for the merry-go-round wouldn't go around without the little white horse and the mare.
The calliope played the wedding march, all the animals began to sing.
The zebra winked at the tall giraffe as the mare took the little brass ring.
Now the little white horse and the little gray mare still honeymoon round and round.
You'll always see them at the fair, for the merry-go-round wouldn't go around. The musical ride would all break down, and the little brass ring wouldn't mean a thing. Without the little white horse and the mare,
without the little white horse and the mare.
Well, Henry, me and Andy done sent in the baby picture to the contest more than a week ago, and we ought to be getting the $500 prize money any day now.
Yes, I see. You feels that the infant is charming enough to grab the first prize, huh?
Oh, we can't miss. What a baby. Why, when I look at the picture of that sweet, innocent little baby, it just made me wish for one of my own. Oh, fatherhood, fatherhood. What could be more maternal?
Yes. Well, babies are something to be proud of, all right.
Oh, you said something there, Henry. I know my folks was proud of me when I was a baby.
Well, I'm not too sure about that, Kingfish. Not if what I done heard is correct.
Oh, what's that?
Well, I hear that a short time after you was born, your father went around demanding his cigars back.
Oh, wait a minute. Look here. Look who's coming, Andy. Here's Andy coming here. He all excited looking. Look at him there.
Hey, Kingfish, I just got the letter. We done won the contest.
Oh, we done won it? Oh, great, and agreed. Like I was saying before, Henry, there's nothing like a baby. Oh, fatherhood, oh, babyhood.
And don't forget the 500 prize.
Oh, moneyhood, oh, yeah.
Take it easy, Kingfish. I ain't told you about the catching the thing.
Don't tell me the contest is crooked.
Yes, what seems to be the trouble?
Well, the letter part is okay, but it's the P.S. that's the trouble.
Mm.
It say that the mother and father has got to appear in person at the camera company to get the prize money.
Oh, me.
Well, it don't look like you was going to get any money. In that case, gentlemen, I'll be running along. Goodbye.
Oh, what is we going to do now, Andy?
Oh, I don't know. It's a mess.
Say, wait a minute, Andy. This is a break. Here comes Gabby Gibson, our lawyer. Yeah, he is just a man that might help us.
Yeah.
Come in, Gabby.
Oh, hello, boy. Just passing by. I thought I'd drop in.
Glad you did, Gabby. We in a jam here. And as a lawyer, you might be able to help us.
Sorry, boy. I just put in 10 hours working in my office. 10 hours. And I'm through working for the day. My working day is over.
Oh, but Gabby, you gotta help us.
Sorry, boys. My day is over.
This matter revolves $500.
A new day just dawned.
Yeah.
What's the case, boys? What's the case?
Well, Gabby, you remember us telling you confidential last week about us entering a pitcher in the baby contest?
Oh, yes, the baby contest. The pitcher you got is shortest. Tell me, did it win the prize?
Yes, no, and maybe.
You certainly grooved that one right in the middle, didn't you?
Yeah,
here, Gabby, read this letter.
Mm-hmm, let me see what it says. Dear Mr. Brown, mm-hmm, that's wonderful. That's great. Sensational.
Now read the P.S.
They certainly can't ruin the letter, can't they?
Yeah, now, what does we do about that, Gabby?
Well, before I read the last part, I'm going to say you boys were sitting pretty. The case was ipso facto.
Yeah, well, after reading the last part, what do you think?
You see, the complexion done changed. In the legal profession, you is no longer what is known as ipso facto.
Well, what is we know it as?
Upso creco, upso creco.
Yeah, now look here, what does we do about it, though, Gabby? That is the question.
Oh, wait a minute, boys. I think I got it. Andy, the letter's addressed to you, and they think you is the father. Now, all we got to do now is get a mother. Who can we get for a mother?
Say, I know. I got an idea, Andy. I know exactly who. I know just the one.
Who?
Your landlady.
Oh, you mean that homely old mean face?
Andy, this is no time to select faces. What you got to have now is a body.
Yeah, well, listen, how is I going in there and ask her to pretend to be the mother of my baby, though?
Yeah, well, now, look here. Just play up to her, Andy. Play up to her. Make her think that you are crazy about her, and take my word for it, she'll do anything for you.
Well, all right. I hope I'm doing the right thing. Hello, Miss McDaniel. I just thought I'd drop in.
Have you got the room rent?
Oh, look, Miss McDaniel, why has we always got to be talking about the room rent?
What else you want to talk about?
Me and you. Miss McDaniel, I might as well tell you, all I think about is you. From the first moment I done set eyes on you. Let me sit down on the sofa there and whisper sweet nothings in your ear.
Listen, if you got any sweet nothings to say to me, don't whisper them. Bark him right out where I can hear him.
Yeah, well, you does like me a little, don't you? You don't hate me, does you?
Hate you? With the shortage of men around here, I can't afford to hate nothing that wears pants.
Sit down on the sofa.
You don't mind if I call you Hattie, does you?
That's my name.
Yeah, well, there's something I want to ask you.
There is?
Yeah, now, this is going to be a kind of a sudden to you.
Sit close, Andy. What does you want to ask me?
I don't know how you're going to take it.
Well, ask me. That's the best way to find out. What do you want to ask me, darling?
Would you be the mother of my baby?
What?
The mother of our baby.
What was that?
I mean Shorty's baby.
Shorty? Who's Shorty?
Oh, me. I was all mixed up here. Let me explain the whole thing to you.
Yeah, and I'm telling you right now, you're going to have to explain this good.
Yeah, well, look, Hattie. Here's the thing in a nutshell. If you believe, if you make believe that you was the mother in the baby picture contest I done entered, I'm going to win enough money to pay you the rent. Is it a deal?
Well, if it mean I'm going to get my rent, it's a deal.
Oh, thank you, Hattie. My troubles is over.
Arinso Whitewash.
With ease.
Arinso Brightwash.
With safety.
Is it any wonder that women here, there, everywhere are singing...
Rinso white
for a wash that's white as it can be. Rinso bright.
B-R-I-G-H-T.
Yes, Rinso keeps your colors bright. Get out more dirt for a wash so white. Here's great advice, you can't go wrong.
Rinso white.
Rinso bright. Happy little wash day song.
You can't beat a Rinso wash for results. So put Soapy Rich Rinso Suds to work on your wash. Just as little as a 10-minute soak, then a few quick finger rubs, and rinse. You'll turn out a wash that's something to sing about. Rinso white and Rinso bright.
And Rinso puts an end to wash day sneezing spells.
Yes, ma'am. Rinso is anti-sneeze. It's made by an exclusive anti-sneeze process and is 98% free of sneezy soap dust. No other granulated soap can make this claim. So next wash day, remember, a Rinso white wash...
with ease.
A Rinso bright wash...
with safety.
It sure is some office this camera supply company got you, ain't it?
Yeah, sure is. I wonder when they're going to call us in.
I ain't going to sit here much longer.
Yeah, who is this?
I take it you're Mr. and Mrs. Brown.
That's right.
Yeah, that's us. And this is my friend, George Stevens.
How you do, sir?
How do you do? I'm Hanover Smith, the president of the company. Mr. Brown, I wonder if you'd step into the next office and identify the picture of your baby, or just as a formality. My secretary has it in there.
Oh, sure. Be glad to do it. I'll do it right away.
Well, Mrs. Brown, I guess you're quite surprised at having your baby win the prize.
Yeah, I was even surprised at having the baby.
Oh, I think I understand. Born a little early, eh?
Yeah, sir. That's it, Mr. Smith. That's it, exactly.
Say, I couldn't quite tell from the picture. What is the baby, a boy or girl?
Boy or girl? It's a girl.
A little girl. Oh, how nice.
Oh, yes, sir. Little girls make great children, all right.
Yes. Well, I hope this little baby has a big brother or sister to keep her company.
Oh, yes. The Browns has got 4 other children, ain't you, Miss Brown?
Oh, sure. Wouldn't be without them.
Well, that certainly is.
Well, I just checked the picture and everything's all right. Oh, what a baby that I was the father of. My little sonny boy. Sonny boy.
Sonny boy? Why, Mrs. Brown, you just told me the baby was a girl.
Oh, yeah. Sonny girl.
Take it easy, Daddy.
It's just a case of me. I got a bad memory, because just with one child, I ought to be able to remember whether it's a boy or a girl. I got to jot that down so I don't forget it again.
I'd keep a record of that if it was my child, if I was you, Anna.
Why, Mrs. Brown, didn't you tell me you had 4 other children?
That's right.
Well, Mr. Brown just said you only had 1 child.
He never could count.
They're just joking with you, Mr. Smith. Great joke, huh?
Oh, I see. Well, you people are certainly fortunate in having such a wonderful baby. And what impresses me more is that the baby's so healthy looking, especially after being born early.
Yeah, well, that being born early didn't hurt the baby a bit. We let her take a nap later in the day.
What was that?
Look, I don't want to rush nobody, but when does we get the prize money?
Yeah. What about that, Miss Smith?
Well, this is a little embarrassing. Now, mind you, not that I doubt for a minute that you're the parents of the baby, but I'll just have to ask you to bring the baby up here with you before I can award you the prize money.
Yeah, but I don't know why you can't give me the prize money right now.
Well, let me put it this way. We wouldn't want anyone that isn't the baby's father to get the money, would we?
Yeah. I mean, no.
So you bring the baby up here, and I'll give you the check. Good day.
Well, how about that? You'd think I was dishonest or something.
Andy, beginning now, I ain't your wife no more, which I ain't know how. And beginning tonight, I is your landlady the same as I is your wife, which I ain't.
Now, don't get under the curse, Andy. We still has one chance that we can get the baby from Shorty.
Yeah, but that cameraman is mighty suspicious. We liable to get in trouble account of that baby.
Yeah, this is the first time I have ever heard of a child contributing to the delinquency of an adult.
Yeah, well, I hope Shorty knows where the baby is. Then we can collect.
Yeah, well, we'll soon find out. Here's the barbershop here now.
Oh, hiya, fellas.
Hello, Shorty, hello.
Shorty, we got some business to discuss with you.
Yeah, but I can't loan you no money.
No, Shorty, this will make you money. Mm. Tell me this, is that baby picture that you had on the wall anywhere around Harlem?
Oh, so.
Oh, good, the baby's around you, huh? Good, now tell you what, Shorty, we'll give you $10 if we can borrow the baby for about 1 hour.
Yeah, that's a deal. Give me the $10.
Okay. Here it is right here. Now, where is the baby?
Right here. That's a picture of me 40 years ago.
Well, poor Andy didn't get his $500, so he's still in trouble. But here's Harlow Wilcox to tell you how to save yourself a lot of trouble this time of year.
Well, it's the time of year for spring cleaning. And one way to cut hours of hard work out of your schedule is to use Rinso for all your soap and water jobs. Woodwork, walls, tiles, linoleum, windows, everything comes sparkling bright quickly and easily with Soapy Rich Rinso. It's swell for dishes, too, and so easy on your hands. So get Rinso for house cleaning, for dishwashing, and for a wash that's Rinso white, Rinso bright.
Well, that's just about the way I would have said it. Get Rinso.
Yeah, do that. Good night, folks.
Be sure to be with us next Friday evening at this same time when the makers of Rinso will again present the Amos and Andy Show. Our program is broadcast to our fighting men all over the world through the facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. This is Harlow Wilcox saying good night to all of you from all of us and reminding you that 1 pound of used fats brings you cash plus 2 red ration points. 1 pound of used fats helps supply enough medicine to care for a wounded serviceman for 12 days. Ladies, saving used fats is your war job. Don't fall down on it. Save every drop of used fats and greases in a clean tin can. When the can is full, take it to your butcher right away. You'll get cash plus 2 red ration points for every pound.
Calling all fathers, important information for you.
Swan is pure as fine Castile. See how smooth your hands will feel. Baby mild for everything. Swan's the soap that makes us sing.
Swan for baby, for your bath, for dishes, light laundry. That is all. That is plenty.
This is the National Broadcasting Company.